What is going on in Houston, Texas? I'm really counting down. The light is running out on me. And look, I'm sorry I'm putting out this video this late, but you should have been up early in the morning tuning in to my live stream, because we had one hell of a conversation. So if you haven't had a chance to go and listen to that conversation, please do so, because I put the AB conversation, let's say, to the coffin, 6 feet and under, and I don't ever want to bring it. Now today, not only do I have tea in my cup, that good tea, but I got some good tea for you guys here discussing the Houston Texans. It's time to start thinking about the players that the Houston Texans can really realistically bring in, according to what John McClain and Aaron Wilson have come out and said. Now, they've reported that the Texans want to bring in 5 extra players to this roster, and 3 of those position groups are: 1, a defensive end or a defensive lineman; 2, an offensive lineman; 3, and safety depth. And the other 2, of course, they did not name, so those are open. It really got me thinking about the options that we have. And look, yes, we have a $20 million shopping spree with the Houston Texans. I don't think that they will, especially with what's being reported at the amount of players that they want, are going to take one player and pay them $16 million. Yes, that does eliminate Everson Griffin from the conversation, but it does not eliminate people like Harrison Snacks, who I think would be one hell of an addition. But today, we're going to talk about a player that the Indianapolis Colts released early on this year, as you guys can tell by the thumbnail. Mr. Jabal Sheard, man. A Super Bowl champion, a Pro Bowler, someone who, if you look at the tape, especially when he faced the Houston Texans with the Indianapolis Colts, man, he was getting after Deshaun Watson. And anyone that can rush a mobile quarterback, I am all for that. You definitely need that, especially with who you face early on this year in the Kansas City Chiefs, in the Baltimore Ravens. You need people that are not going to get tired of chasing the quarterback, that know about scrambling quarterbacks and how to keep them in the pocket. And those are things that we definitely need on this team. Obviously, our defensive coordinator is Mr. Exotic Anthony Weaver. And look, I believe that he is the type of coach that's going to want to keep players with fresh legs. After all, that's exactly what happened with the Bills and the Jets when he was part of that coaching staff. And when you really get to studying that tape, you'll notice the amount of defensive backs, of safeties, of upfront pressure that they bring. And it just has offenses on their toes because they don't know where it's coming from. And in order to do that, you have to bring in talented players, veteran players, players that have done it before. And I believe that Mr. Jabal Sheard is one of them. And look, one of the most interesting things that I noticed about Jabal Sheard was that last year the Colts switched him from the left to the right. Now we have a player that not only has played on the left and right of the line, he's played down the center. He's also played linebacker when he was with the Browns and was actually pretty good at it. So, we're talking about a player that's versatile. I'm going to say that again. We're talking about a player that's versatile. Whisper that in O'Brien's ear, and the dude is melting away. I really think that this is a guy who we haven't heard much of when it comes to, you know, the interest from other teams with him. A guy that, when he left the Patriots to join the Indianapolis Colts, he had a 3-year deal. I think it was over $20 million a deal a year. And the only reason why the Colts released him was because they had a younger person under him. But when you're talking about veterans, when you're talking about adding players that can really be impactful, that can be leaders in the locker room, look no further than Mr. Jabal Sheard, man. Look, he can average anywhere from 6 to 8 sacks a season, and the guy has one hell of a step, man, from the bat, from the gate. And look, you're going to need to allow Ross Blacklock to really adjust to the NFL speed, and how, not else, by bringing in a leader who can really assist him with that. And think about it. If you can bring in Sheard for, let's say, a 1-year deal, $3.5 to $4 million, or a 2-year deal, up to $7 million, you're talking about adding a player for cheap who can really be impactful on this team. And like I said, let's be honest. If they're trying to add in all these position groups, they're going to have to spread those $20 million around. Not to mention that I'm pretty sure O'Brien wants to save some for during the season adjustments that he might have to make, a.k.a. like with COVID, when he had to go down, or when injuries happen. It's just what happens in the NFL, and O'Brien has learned his lesson from that, and I'm pretty sure he wants to be ready to add if he needs to. So, look, if they add three of those five players, that means that the most that you could possibly add is anywhere from, I want to say, $10 to $13 million within those three players, which means you have to look at players that are not going to demand big contracts. How much snacks will demand, I'm not sure, but I think Jabbar Sheard is one hell of an option, someone you can bring in on the cheap and can be very impactful on this team. Not to mention, how motivated would he be to know that he would come to a team where he can face the Indianapolis Colts twice that year, get a little bit of revenge off of being released, man. And that really is what I think will motivate him to come to Houston if Houston gets to dealing with him, man. So, hey, that would be very exciting to add to this defense, man. I think it's something that nobody is talking about, but I think it needs to be talked about. And, hey, man, what's important, what's the priority right now, I think, is the defense. So I give up adding talent to the defense anytime over the offense. And that is a straight fact. Hey, man, it is Sunday, a fresh new week. You guys take it easy. You know what it is every day, baby.